What's going on, my friends? This is Dustin Stelzer with Electrician U. Today we are going to continue the case of the missing J-box covers. All right, so recently I did a video. You can click up here if you want to go watch it, but it was last week's video on a whole bunch of code violations that I found while I was at this 100-year-old building up in Massachusetts. One of the things we talked about is the fact that in code, I at least don't know of anywhere in code where it specifically says any kind of conductors, any kind of boxes, junction boxes, things like that, have to actually be closed with a cover. There is language that 600 volts and above that specifically does say, yes, you need to make sure that the box is closed, but anything under doesn't really say. But there is somebody that left a code ref in the comments. Jay Carter, thank you so much for pointing this out. There's actually another code reference that I missed, and it is 314.25, and it talks about covers. So Jay's comment, just for the credit that I need to give him, NEC 314.25 requires that covers shall be installed after completed installations. I challenge that though. I do appreciate you writing it, and this is exactly what I like. It's not somebody flaming up and being pissed off and trying to shit on somebody. It's like, no, here's my code reference, here's my case, go check it out. That is perfect. So thank you so much, Jay. All right, so let's look up 314.25, shall we? So when I was doing the video, I was looking at 314.28 because that deals with pull and junction boxes and conduit bodies. So my like viewing into where I thought this was gonna be in code was not behind this, it was from there forward. So I just didn't look back. But there is something, 314.25, that says covers and canopies. Now it's still within the installation section. So I know that I'm not in some weird obscure section that doesn't apply to the situation. It's in part two, which is installation. Same thing as 314.28, same part. So 314.25, covers and canopies, it says in completed installations, each box shall have a cover, faceplate, lamp holder, or luminaire canopy, except where the installation complies with 410.24B, which is LED luminaire, doesn't have anything to do with what we're doing. Screws used for the purpose of attaching covers and other equipment to the box shall be either machine screws matching the thread gauge and size that is integral to the box, or shall be in accordance with the manufacturer's instructions. So what that says is still not specific. It's still not to the point of what I was trying to get at. Doesn't say it has to be installed. It just says it has to be provided with, which is the same thing that 314.28 says. It needs to be provided with a cover. Now we're not talking about the stuff over 1,000 volts, which is part four, where we're talking in 314.72 C and E, where it's very specific that says these boxes need to be closed with a cover. The language in 314.25 specifically says in completed installations, each box shall have a cover. Now, have a cover doesn't say whether or not the cover needs to be installed. It needs to be provided in 314. I know, I'm picking hairs here. You can get all pissed off at me, write comments, that's fine. I'm fully expecting it. But the language in the 600 volt and up says it needs to be installed. It needs to be closed. 314.25 says in completed installations, each box shall have a cover. Doesn't mean, you know, maintenance person comes up, takes the cover off, throws it away. What about allowing like a hingeable cover where you leave the hinge open? It's provided with a cover. Doesn't say it has to be closed in here. It just, it's got a cover, it's provided. What if you take a 1900 box or 2100 box and you have a blank plate on the top of it and you unloosen a screw and you slide the plate open to work on it? Is there anything that says that you have to close that in code? No, cover's provided, it's there, it's just not on it. What if you wanted to leave conductors dangle because you couldn't fit everything back in? It's a crappy install, like don't do that. They make extension rings for that. But I'm just saying, if we're going by the very specific language of this book, it's filled with very specific wording. They use shall, or shall be permitted, or they use very, very specific language. So if they're talking about things that are 600 volts and more, and they use very specific language on making sure these boxes are closed, why are they not in 314.28 or 314.25 saying that? Now, it is at least arguable they say in completed installations. In a completed installation, say you're going and installing a system, conduit system, yes, you have to make it a complete installation, you need to go put covers on your boxes. Doesn't say you gotta keep them closed, but you do have to provide them. I think it just needs to be more specific. So I still stand by what I said, that I just haven't come across a code yet that under 600 volts requires these boxes to be closed. So I don't really know if that is truly a code violation, having the covers removed and maybe removed and put above the ceiling grid. It's still provided, it's still right there, but it's not closed. So, as I know you're already doing, write your opinions, your comments below, but please, like Jay did, at least cite what your argument is, cite your opinion. It can be an opinion, that's fine, but don't just be like,
nah, it's code.
Nobody's gonna listen to you. Nobody cares what you have to say if you're not at least pulling this book out and trying to read and find things. And if you do find me wrong, bro, I'm so comfortable with being wrong. I'm a field electrician. Like, I'm used to just being wrong, being proved wrong. Inspectors, other electricians, like, that's how we learn code. Nobody learns code by, like, reading this book. And, you know, the people that write the book probably know code better than anybody because they're constantly in it. Most of them aren't out in the field though. So as actual field electricians that are out there working every day, the way that we consume code is on job sites. We go to a job, we look at like, how do we do this thing? Okay, let's open it up. Where we look over here and it's like, oh crap, is that code? Who knows? I'm gonna go out and look, you know? So even journeymen that have a smaller understanding maybe, if they're like a fresh journeyman, they're still gonna be teaching apprentices code. They don't know everything, but they're still trying to teach what they do know. And even master electricians trying to teach, you know, journeymen and teach apprentices, they probably know a lot more, but nobody knows everything in this book right off the top of their dome. Nobody's run into every single possible thing as that you could do ever as an electrician and memorize the entire code book. So you gotta have some levity. When we talk about code, there's people that love to just shit on other people when somebody gets something wrong or doesn't see something. You shouldn't be doing that. We gotta realize all of us are in this boat together. We're all out in the field. We're all learning as we are getting experience, as we are coming across things. And the best thing that can happen is that you don't know something and that you talk to somebody and everybody combined tries to figure out a solution. Somebody reads articles and goes reads magazines and pulls out the code book and then everybody gets together and they're like, boom, dude, I found it. Everybody just learned. So even if I say something that is completely incorrect, everybody in the comments that's catching it and talking about it, it's still of high value because we're all learning something together. So I'm totally comfortable with being wrong. It means that I've learned something and now I know a new thing and there's just more that's building inside of my mind. So I love it. Please leave comments below. Thank you guys so much for watching everything that you do and supporting everything that you do. Please make sure you sub, like, and hit the notification bell that you join the Discord server. Join the Discord server so we can keep doing these, but actually like in real time with everybody. So it's not just you waiting on me to like possibly answer a question in a video or Facebook if that's more your jam, or Meta, all the metaverse. I don't know what we're all gonna do with these Facebook groups once they change to Meta. We're not gonna get into that now. I love you crazy people and I'll see you soon.
Descant music and video.